Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I'm Yan Peiyu from Tsinghua University, Beijing, China. I'm very glad to meet some old friends again in this webinar. It is my honor to give you a presentation about the hydration of slag in complex bender and the microstructure variation of hardened paste on the condition of leaching of soft water. First, I should introduce the status of Chinese cement and concrete industry. China is the largest developing country. There is a huge need for the infrastructure construction now. So we consume great amount of building material, especially cement and concrete. The cement annual output of China keeps higher than 2 billion tons since 2010, accounting for more than 60% of the world cement output. The top one was 2.476 billion tons in 2014, and 2.33 billion tons in last year, 2019. It is estimated that more than 5 billion cubic meters of the concrete was produced in 2019. The average containing rate of clinker in Chinese cement is less than 2/3. Others use mineral admixture such as slag, fresh limestone, and porcelain. Large amount of mineral admixture is added directly into concrete mixture during its preparation. Totally more than 1 billion tons of mineral admixture include more than 200 million tons of GGBS is used in Chinese cement and concrete industry. Fresh and GGBS are the indispensable SCMs in Chinese ready-mix concrete industry. Silica film is used only for high-strength concrete. Normally, 20 to 40% of bender is SCM in concrete. SCM should be used in high ratio if concrete used in an aggressive environment or to make a massive element. High-strength concrete used also lots of SCM. These are the real used concrete mix proportion in a ready-mix concrete company. In Beijing, we use only PO42.5 ordinary Portland cement. It contains about 20% SCM, such as fresh GGBS limestone powder or other solid waste. It can be seen that 25 to 40% of SCMs is added additionally to prepare concrete. There are many fresh and GGBS. Both of them are used complexly at the same time. These are some examples of shoop high rising buildings which use high volume SCM concrete to cast their massive foundations. This is a new CCTV tower in Beijing. It was finished in 2007. This is Shanghai tower. It is 632 meters high. It's the highest buildings in China now. Shenzhen Ping An Financial Center is 600 meters high. It's finished at 2011. Beijing City Tower is 528 meters high. It is the highest building in Beijing. It was finished last year. These are the concrete mix proportion of foundations for these buildings. The strength class is between C40 to C50. The dosage of SM is more than 40%. The used cement is PO42.5. It contains 20% of SM. Therefore, total dosage of SM is more than 60%. It benefits to reduce the exothermic effect of binder and to eliminate the thermal cracking of concrete. These are the high-strength concrete mix proportion used in this project. Most of this project use GGBS to prepare high-strength concrete. Flash on the silica film might use or might not use. More than 90% of alkaline blast furnace slag, about 220 million tons annually, is used in cement and concrete industry in China. It is used to produce blended cement or added directly into concrete as SCMs. The hydration characteristics of GGBS was studied intensively to understand its effect on the hydration mechanism of binder and the mechanical property and durability of concrete. These are the hydration exothermal right curves of blended binder containing different ratio of GGBS at different temperature with water binder ratio of 0.4. Hydration exothermal right of binder decreases with the increase of percentage of GGBS in binder. Hydration exothermal right of binder increases obviously along with the elevation of hydration temperature. The exothermal effect of cement and GGBS is separated and continuous long period at room temperature. The elevated temperature accelerate the hydration of cement and especially GGBS. The exothermic effect cannot separate and the keeping time shortens. These are the hydration heat curves of blended binder containing different ratio of GGBS at different temperature with water binder ratio of 0.4. The hydration heat of binder with middle dosage of slag increases obviously along with the elevation of hydration temperature. The hydration heat of blended binder decreases obviously when the dosage of GGBS is higher than 70%, especially at elevated temperature. These figures show the increases of reaction degree of GGBS in blended binder at different temperature. In room temperature, the reaction degree of GGBS is low in early age, but increases obviously in late age. The reaction degree decreases with the increase of GGBS dosage, but the influence of dosage is not obvious when GGBS dosage is lower than 70%. The reaction degree of GGBS cured at elevated temperature is higher in early age, but increases a little in. This is the pH value of pore solution in hardened paste. the pH value of pool solution in the paste containing GGBS is lower than pool cement paste, but is kept higher than 12. This alkalinity is enough to keep CSH stable and avoid its carbonation. Alkalinity of pool solution varies a little when GGBS dosage is in the range of 30% to 70% between 25 centigrade and 60 centigrade. Calcium hydroxide content in binder paste decreases with the increase of dosage of GGBS because the reaction of GGBS consumes calcium hydroxide formed by the hydration of cement. Calcium hydroxide content in binder paste in late age is about 6% for binder containing 70% of GGBS. Therefore, the pH value of pore solution can be kept at an enough high level to ensure the stability of CSHG. The morphologies of binder paste cured for only 3 days show that the hydration degree of binders is high both at room temperature and the elevated temperature. There are lots of hydration product to form a dense paste structure. Morphologies of binder paste cured for 1.5 years show that the paste is also very dense. There is a lot of hydration products. This is the compressive strength of mortar, tested by the ISO method. The strength of binders containing GGBS no more than 70% is higher than cement after 28 days. Early strength of binders containing GGBS higher than 70% is low. Because of the pH value of blended binder paste is lower than that of pour cement paste, some people are worried about the instability of hardened product and the corrosion of rebar in concrete, especially for those projects such as dam frame, which contact directly with flowing soft water continuously. There is a risk of alkalinity decreases due to the loss of calcium hydroxide. The criterion of instability is the calcium hydroxide is consumed in the paste. Calcium silicate ratio of CSH gel decreases to a limit, resulting in its decomposition. The pore structure of paste decreases seriously to increase its porosity and lose the interconnected of hydration product. The influencing factors of instability is dosage of SM, activity of SM, and contacting with flowing soft water. Therefore, we do some investigation on the effect of leaching of soft water on the binder paste containing GGBS. The mix proportion of the sample is, the first is poor ordinary Portland cement. The second one is 70% ordinary Portland cement plus 30% GGBS. The third one is 30% ordinary Portland cement plus 70% GGBS. After demolding, Group B samples was cured for 90 days in water at 20 centigrade. Group C samples was cured in water at 65 centigrade for 7 days, then at 20 centigrade till the hydration age of 9 days. After curing, sample was cut to the thin bread of 2 to 3 millimeters. The leaching process and the test method. The samples cured for 9 days were immersed in still water. Water was renewed at regular intervals. The surface layer of specimens was cut and put into acetone to cease hydration at the age of 90 days, 1 year, and 2 years. The calcium hydroxide content was determined by TG. Pore size and pore size distribution of the hardened paste were measured with MIP. The macromorphology of paste and the calcium silica ratio of CSH gel was investigated by SEM-EDS. The cumulative mass loss rate of the hardened paste after leaching is tested and calculated. These are the XRD patterns of hardened paste before leaching and after 2 years leaching. Compare the two patterns. We can see that the main hydration product is calcium hydroxide. After a long period of leaching, the peak strength of calcium hydroxide decreases little. The quantity of calcium hydroxide does lose little. There is almost low variance of the main hydration product. Calcium hydroxide content in hardened paste before leaching. The higher the dosage of GGBS, the lower calcium hydroxide content. The normalized calcium hydroxide content in the composite binder paste is higher at early age and almost the same, even higher in late age, than that in pore cement paste. After 2 years leaching, calcium hydroxide content reduces slightly for all three series of paste. There is still enough quantity of calcium hydroxide in the paste containing large volume of GGBS. It ensures the high alkalinity of pore solution and the stability of CSH gel. It is foreseeable that CSH gel will not resolve in a much long leaching period. The calcium silica ratio of CSH gel in the binder paste containing GGBS before leaching. The higher the percentage of GGBS in complex binder, the lower the calcium silica ratio of CSH gel. The cumulative mass loss rate of hardened complex binder paste during the leaching process. The mass loss rate of paste is low as the GGBS content increases. The mass loss of binder containing GGBS is even lower than that of pore cement. The pore structure of paste after long time leaching of soft water. The porosity of cement GGBS paste is much lower. It is still dense and does not show an increased trend after long period of leaching. With a prolongation of leaching age, the gel pores smaller than 4.5 nanometer increases the micropore of 4.5 to 50 nanometer decreases gently, but the larger pore of 50 to 100 nanometer and larger than 100 nanometer does not increase obviously. We can see the very dense paste before the lynching, and also a very dense paste after 2 years lynching. There are lots of hydration product in the paste, and this did not decompose. The paste microstructure does not destroy by long time lynching. Now come to conclusion. There is not a decomposition of hydration product, obviously loss of calcium hydroxide, and the decrease of density of binder paste after long period of leaching by soft water. The porosity of cement GGBS paste is lower than poor cement paste. It shows an excellent anti-leaching performance. In cement GGBS paste, calcium hydroxide content decreases and its alkalinity reduces with the dosage of GGBS. After a long period of leaching, there is still enough quantity of calcium hydroxide to keep the alkalinity of pore solution and ensure the stability of hydration products. Thank you for your attention.